there! Today we're talking about the plumb line. The plumb line is an imaginary line going through your ear, shoulder, hip, knee, and ankle joints. Try to get everything stacked one on top of each other, but don't fret if you don't have perfect alignment. None of us do. You can see in my video, I don't either. So let's get started. First, shake it all off so you're starting fresh. Starting down at the feet, we want them hip distance apart. And I find the easiest way to get there is to start in first position ballet, if you know what that is, meaning your heels are together and your toes are pointed out at a 45 degree angle. Now move your heels out so the outside of your feet are parallel. Move back and forth, side to side, so you find where it feels like your weight is falling on all four corners of your feet. Next, we'll move up to the knees. You want them straight, but not hyperextended. So you want a micro bend in the knees. Moving up to the hips, find that pointy spot on the front of your hips. Place your fingers there with your thumbs going around the sides towards the back. You want to roll your hips under. So you take the arch out of your back and you engage the lower abs. Move that same hand position up to your lower ribs. Take a deep breath in. And engage those upper abs and bring the lower ribs down towards the hips so they don't flare out. Roll your shoulders up, back, and down, and bring your shoulder blades towards each other behind you. Final step is to look straight ahead so your eyes are parallel to the ground. That's all there is to it. So next, let's quickly look at it from the side. Feet are hips distance apart. And the outside edge of the feet are parallel. Knees are straight with a micro bend in them. Hips are rolled under, so the arch is taken out of your back, and the lower ribs are rolled down as well, so they aren't flaring out. Shoulders are up, down, and around, and you're looking straight ahead. Let me know what you think.